Welcome back, Classic Gamers, and thanks for viewing Jay the Classic Gamer's Let's Play Swords and Serpents for the NES Part 6. When we last left off, we explored Level 5, learned the Pass Wall spell, and got a mirror shield on Level 3. With that said, let's check out Level 6.
Welcome to Shocker.
The first enemy we face is a phantom, and it's dead just like that. I guess this phantom wants an ass whooping too. Ask and you shall receive. I guess these phantoms will never learn. Uh-oh, watch out, a couple mages. Wow, these guys are really easy.
Claire is awarded the chain for kicking so much ass.
That's going to be an upgrade for Jay. Uh-oh, three mages. I find it kind of weird that the mages on level 3 are harder than these guys. But these mages do get a lot of attacks also. Psychedelic death.
When walls become barriers on the path to victory, turn left. To fly as a bird would leave low concerns behind.
Whatever in the hell that means. Oh, watch out now. Four Incredible Hulk zombies. My characters are getting pretty strong at this point. These zombies aren't as hard as they used to be.
You have found a brass key. Jay is holding it.
I got a little confused here. I didn't know exactly what I wanted to do. But I'm just gonna go ahead and pass through the north wall. Uh-oh, three mages and green robes. I bet these guys are pretty hard. Let's find out. No, they're pretty weak too.
Jack is awarded the chain for kicking so much ass.
Three zombies prepare to be destroyed. Uh-oh, three knights. I bet these guys would be tough. They do hit pretty hard.
Jay
Nobody is safe from Jack's one-hit kill. Oh yeah, it's time to pwn some mages. Wow, this battle's becoming a little drawn out. And the very next step we take, we encounter three more knights. Three knights that just got their asses handed to them. Four zombies, come get you some. And finally, they go down. And looky what we have here. Three more knights that must die. You cannot defeat me, zombies. Come get your ass whooping. Button smash for the win. Three more knights, prepare to die. We'll find out what's behind this door in a few seconds.
Teleporter activated!
The teleporter teleports you to the first room on this level. Hyper fast ass whooping. Here we go, three phantoms. Alright, three mages, you asked for it. Thank you.
player is awarded the glow sword for kicking so much ass.
That's going to be an upgrade for Jay. I will lose 2 armor class, but I'll gain 4 damage, and I get 2 attacks with it. Oh great, some more mages. Yeah, 3 more mages, blah blah blah. You can imagine that, 3 more mages. Really? 3 more mages? It's about time we see something different. Where's a shotgun when you need one? I don't need a shotgun, I'll just kill him the old-fashioned way. What a shocker, 3 more mages.
Merle is awarded the chain for kicking so much ass.
This may appear to be a dead end, but there's actually a secret door here.
Magic fountain magicians may drink and replenish all their magic points.
Awesome! Whoa, 4 knights! Did I mention that I love Jack's one-hit kills? Wow, 4 more knights.
Chuck is awarded the silver sword for kicking so much ass.
That is not an upgrade. Behind this wall is the stairs to level 7, but let's not go there yet. No brains for you, only psychedelic death. Thank you.
These two lame-ass knights don't stand a chance.
The rest of this room is filled with traps, so I'm going to use the flight spell to avoid all the traps. But look what happens to Merle's magic points when I cast a spell. I mind you that this spell only costs one magic point. That's bullshit. I lost all my magic points.
There's one good thing about walking where traps are, at least there's no enemies. The words to a thunder spell are written here.
This is a very cool spell. It can do damage to two enemies. Now let's head south. Behind this wall you will find a secret passage.
You have found secret level beta.
You don't stand a chance, mage. All I went to do here was cast the shield spell, but look what happens to Claire's magic points. That's bullshit. Now I'm pissed. I'm gonna take it out on these phantoms. I'm still confused on where my magic points went. Oh yeah, mages, I'm still pissed. I'm gonna take it out on you.
You have found a ruby shield. Jay is holding it.
And yes, that's going to be an upgrade for Jay. Now let's walk through this wall.
Magic fountain. Magicians may drink and replenish all their magic points.
Awesome! Alright, I'm not pissed off anymore, as long as they don't take away my magic points again. Zombie killing time!
You have found a ruby ring. Jay is holding it.
That's going to be an upgrade for Merle. Behind this wall is a teleport to level 1. I'm not going to show you this, it would only be a waste of time. How many times am I going to have to whoop these mages' asses before they get the memo? Psychedelic death. Now it's time to open a can of whoop ass on these four knights.
Thank you.
Button smash for the win. The mages are starting to get very annoying.
Is awarded the silver helmet for kicking so much ass.
And since you kick so much ass, Merle, we're going to give you that silver helmet.
You have found secret level alpha.
If you use the pass wall spell on the south wall, it will lead you to a teleporter to level 1. But I'm not going to show you that. That would only be a waste of time. Let's use the pass wall spell here.
The words to a major hill spell are written here. The words to a major hill spell are written here. The words to a major hill spell are written here. The words to a major hill spell are written here.
Alright, we got the major hill spell. Now what? Oh boy, 3 phantoms. Let me guess, zombies, you want my damn brains.
No, we want your last Twinkie!
You will get neither, my brains or my Twinkies. And behind this door is the stairs to level 7. So this concludes Jay the Classic Gamer's Let's Play Swords and Serpents for the NES Part 6. Thanks again for watching, and be sure to stay tuned for Part 7.